My Financial Coach presents The History of Retirement. In the beginning, retirement was just a distant dream. For the caveman, the idea of growing old into a life of leisure seemed all but impossible, when the average life expectancy was around 30. By the 6th century AD, Augustus, the first Roman emperor, starts the first known pension fund for veterans of the Roman army returning from war. Although Augustus initially uses his own funds, he further enhances this program through inheritance and sales taxes. While the Civil War tore the nation apart, the size and scope of the war also created a population of over 2 million veterans on both sides who needed to be cared for. As a result, a pension system was created as early as 1862 for Union veterans. For Confederate veterans who had lost the war, there would be no federal aid, but each southern state would establish their own state pensions. These pensions would be used as models years later in the introduction of the Social Security Act. While pensions were growing in popularity among both federal and local governments, it wasn't until 1875 that American Express established the first corporate pension. Not long after, in 1880, the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad, of monopoly fame, came up with a different solution that had both employer and employee contributions. This laid the foundation for 401ks nearly 100 years before they became a household name. In 1935, President Franklin D. Roosevelt signed into law the Social Security Act of 1935 as part of his New Deal domestic programs. The law created the Social Security program, as well as insurance against unemployment. Ernest Ackerman was the first recipient of the Social Security benefits, with a lump sum of 17 cents, paid to him in January 1937. By the 60s, pensions were a common corporate retirement benefit. However, in this decade, their safety would be tested. In 1963, the Studebaker Corporation, an automobile manufacturer, closed its plant. Leaving in its wake was a pension plan, so underfunded that Studebaker could not afford to provide all employees with their pensions. As a result of this failure, and with increasing public awareness, thanks to the 1972 NBC television special, Pensions, The Broken Promise, Americans are becoming more conscious of the consequences of poorly funded pension plans and stringent vesting requirements. Thus, the Employee Retirement Income Security Act of 1974 was signed into law, setting the minimum standards for pension plans in private industry. While pensions were facing growing uncertainty in 1978, a provision in Internal Revenue Code, Section 401k, led to a new way for employees to save. At first, it was limited to key executives at companies such as Kodak and Xerox, who pushed for new ways to defer compensation from taxes. The IRS issued new rules that further increased the 401k's popularity by allowing more rank and file employees to fund their 401k through payroll deductions. These plans are so popular now that a Department of Labor survey from 2016 found that 62% of workers had access to some type of defined contribution plan, such as a 401k plan, and of those with access, 72% were participating. We've taken you on a journey through the history of retirement. So what does the future of retirement hold? There are endless opportunities, and My Financial Coach can help you create your own retirement history.